the birthday young man, the birthday 50-year-old, is my third son. I am the mother of the clan. And he is an amazing child, and I know him as being the snowman. He's very articulate, very clean, and he loved his work. He loved the earth, I would say. Ezekiel James Jenkins. Yes, and today is his, well, the other day was the 50th birthday. We're celebrating it today. So I've been in his life for 50 years, telling him yes and telling him no, and what to do and what not to do.
Oh, God. Wow.
Happy birthday, Sister Paula from church. God bless you. Wish you God's blessing and have many, many more birthdays. Love you with the love of Christ. Happy birthday, Bookie.
Happy birthday. I'll see you real soon. Mm-hmm. Live it up. Big 50. Woo! Happy birthday, Uncle. Live it up, big 50.
Hey, man. Happy birthday now. Hey, you big 50 now. Hey. Yep.
Happy birthday to, join me, to you. Happy birthday, Uncle. Okay.
Happy birthday, Buki. It's your favorite cousin in the whole wide world. I love you. Enjoy your years. More to come.
You know you have 100, right? You're half of 100 years old. You old, bro. All right, little brother. I love you. Keep reaching for the sky. Know that God loves you. And peace out. Love you, bro.
Oh, that cornbread turned out nice. Holler at your boy. That turned out really good. That's cake right there. Cake.
Holler at your cornbread.
Cornbread.
What's up, y'all? Welcome to the Old Money Frog. We are now turning to KodaimaCon, but we just thank Ezekiel for his 50 years and all he's been doing in the community for grass and cutting and just being a stand-up man of God. I call him my pastor because you know he preaches to me all the time. But we're so glad that we can provide food today and cook for his 50th, and he put me on a flyer too, so I guess it's my 50th too. This is Shot.
Hello.
This is Danny, and we are KodaimaCon. Bow.
And maybe eat some steak with my beans and rice up. Place where my kids can play outside without living in fear of a drive-by. And even if I get away from them drive-by killers, I still got to worry about those snitch-ass niggas. I keep on searching and I keep on looking, but niggas are the same from Watts to Brooklyn. I try to keep my faith in my people, but sometimes my people be acting like they evil. You don't understand about running with a gang, cause you don't gang.
Happy birthday, James. Yeah, you know. I'm trying to think of some joyful thing to say about you right about now, but I'm really feeling really sarcastic.
Well, I'm going to keep it cool. Happy birthday. You know, I got a lot of things I want to say and probably I should say, because you are a hot mess. And you know I know all your secrets, baby. But I ain't going to speak about it today. Now, I'm older than you. You might think you're older than me. I'm your big sis. And that demands respect. Where's your monkey butt at? It's already, honey. 8:35, Negro. Where you at? We here. We've been here since 2 o'clock. The food is all here. Your guests are here. You rude, Negro. Get your behind on down here. It's time for the party. We all here for you. Okay? Now, happy birthday and all. I'll talk to you later, Negro.
Thank you. As I was saying, I am the only male nephew and cousin in Seattle, Washington. Okay, I'm the only one. I was surrounded by females. That's it. It sucked, man.
Yeah, it's time for him to get here because it's time to go to sleep. I got work tomorrow.
But you can't be on time for your birthday.
You always giving your workers a hard time about being on time.
Right. Let's go.
Set the example. Tell him, nigga.
Yeah, you can be on time for work, but you can't be on time for your birthday party. We're open for you. We all love you.
Where you at?
We want to enjoy your party, but you're not here. Where are you? I'm not his favorite cousin. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you
Hey, Buki, you know, you're my favorite cousin. Because of you, my son has a job, and he basically has a career now, because now you want to be late, and I want to have fun with you, and I barely see my family. So it's a time for you to be here, for us to all hang out and be a family. We got to spend more time together. Besides this party, we got to spend more time together outside of here. But yeah, I love you guys. I love everybody. Especially you, Buki. You're my favorite cousin in the whole world. I love you.
I can say some stuff now. Where are they?
DJ Hawk, all the way from Turtle
Way. What's up, man? This is your guy, Melly Mel, man. I don't even know if I can stay till you get here because you hella late, man. You're late. Your family, your friends, man, they all here, man. We waiting on you. They talking about, where's Zeke at? Where? Come on, man. Happy birthday, my guy, because I might not see you. You know what I mean? But I'm here. Yeah, I'm here. You feel me?
Hey, what's up, Books? Happy 50th birthday, bro. You at half a century. Man, you told me that, you know, your party from 7 to 9 or 7 to 2, but I live 71 miles from here, bro, an hour and 19 minutes, man, so I might not even see you. But one thing I have to tell you is that I love you. You've always been a friend to me. I don't really have that many friends because people always want to be down with what you got, but you always love me for who I am. So one love to you, bro. Make sure you take care of yourself, man. Stay hydrated. We need you. One love.
Yeah.
Allowing me to be the mother of Mr. Ezekiel James Jenkins.
Yay.
Give him a hand.
Yay!
And for 50 years, he has been in my life.
Yes.
And that's a blessing to have a mother for 50 years.
Amen.
Yeah,
it is.
Amen.
I was 28 years old when my mother passed away, and that was a big blow. And she didn't get a chance to see all of my children, but I am so glad today that all of my, I can see my grandchildren. Mm-hmm. And all of my children have had children, I can see their children. It's a blessing, and I thank God for that on today.
Yes.
I thank God for, because God allowed us to have this birthday party.
Amen.
You know, always put God first.
Yes.
I want to tell all you young women and young men today here, I'm 77 and I'm on my way to heaven.
Mm.
Woo!
Hallelujah!
Thank you, Jesus. But let me tell you, be sweet and kind to your mother and your father as long as they are alive.
Amen.
They did the best they could while they was raising you up. Sometimes it was a whole bunch of children. Some of you all don't have a two and can't have this, just a two. and I had six, and sure enough, I almost went crazy.
Hey, come on.
Amen, because raising children is not an easy thing.
No, it ain't.
It's not easy, because when you get, when they get out of size six, they're in the size 10 before they can finish you to buy them a seven. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They grow so fast, and they drink up several gallons of milk in a week. Let me tell you. Eat all the cereals and put the box, in the cupboard.
And the grain.
Amen. Yeah. So
and
I'm talking about children. I'm just being a mama. And I want to praise God for my son, Ezekiel.
Yes.
Now, it's his birthday.
Yes, it is.
And I have other children that are here today. They understand that. Yeah. It's his birthday.
Yeah.
And he always come to me and say, Mom, here's a little something for you to go and get something to eat. Yeah. Don't you that make me feel good?
Yeah.
Sometimes I don't have a 10 cents in my pocket. Woo!
Come on.
But you know what? God always supplies my every need. And I thank God for my son who comes to me every once in a while and says, Mama, here's a little something. It don't be no 25 cents either. I can buy a steak if I want to.
Hey.
I can buy a filet mignon if I want to.
Yeah.
And buy a chicken.
Come on now.
I'm just glad to be here today. Amen. And I thank God for my grandson.
Yes.
Y'all give him a hand.
Hey.
Amen. His name is Ezekiel James Jr.
Yeah.
And today is his birthday.
Yes, it is.
Oh, yes.
Happy birthday.
And I just love him, and he knows that too as well. And I thank God for Miss Alyssa's birthday too.
Hey.
Amen, my son's girlfriend.
Hey.
Say it loud.
I ain't said no girlfriend, she's a woman friend.
Hallelujah. Oh, all right.
Say it loud and proud.
All right, so but we're looking for some wedding bells out the wild.
Hey.
Some joy bells out the wild.
Down there.
Yes, all right. Okay, I think I'm at the end. Brother Anthony. No, I know, I forgot about him. He's the best cook in Salem, Washington.
Hallelujah!
Woo! Watch out. I told you, that's the best food. I don't ever eat cheese and macaroni from anyone. But that I ate all of it. It was so delicious. I'm gonna take some home with me too. Woo!
Your mama said, you know,
I've been knowing these young, old gentlemen for a long time, and it's a blessing to see this 50 years. And more to come. I wish y'all the best, and I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. I love you.
Anyone else?
Be nice.
Come on, Ryan.
That's Ryan.
What's going on, y'all? My name's Ryan Casino, and I've been in Ezekiel's life for about 37 years.
Watch out, sir.
And Zeke has always been a consistent young man. He's always come from a high level of culture and tradition from his family. I'm just very happy to know him. I'm glad that he's still here. And I just love you, and I just, you know, may you continue to stay hydrated and, you know, take care of yourself, and everything will work out. All right, one love, Z. Love you.
Yes, sir.
Can we just
Hello, Jill.
I met Zeke through the last person. I'm Jamel, by the way.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? I met Zeke through the last homie that just spoke.
Ryan.
I met him through Ryan, you know what I mean? And Zeke. I didn't like him at first. I talk to Zeke about this all the time. I didn't like him at first. Zeke, when I first met Zeke, he was just too flossy, like arrogant. Yeah. Did somebody say arrogant? Yeah, there you go. He was just too. I was like, man, I don't like this dude. Man. Throughout the time, hey, he grew on me, man.
And
from back then, in 2022, this is my guy right here.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love this dude, man. You know, I'd do anything for this dude, man. He's that guy. Happy birthday, bro.
I appreciate it.
All day.
Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord!
Now, I'm the baby of the bunch.
Hey, baby.
And he's not always nice.
Watch out, sir. Let me get to the nitty gritty of it.
Go ahead.
So, I love my brother Dev. Not only my brother and Anthony, we all grew up together around the corner from, we're all neighbors.
That's right.
I'm so happy to see that my brother made 50 years on this earth. And I'm very happy to celebrate his birthday with you.
Yes, sir.
My brother had a scare this year that scared me. And I got on my knees and prayed for my brother to make sure that he could be all right. So, he's still here with us. All I ask, I ain't gonna roast him tonight. All I ask is,
bro, come on, man.
I ain't gonna roast him. My oldest brother just walked in.
Watch out! Watch out! Watch out! Watch out! Watch out! Watch out! Watch
out! All I ask is, when you go on your vacation, take your time, relax, keep your feet up. Don't take a weekend vacation. Take a 2 or 3 week vacation and turn your phone off. Enjoy yourself.
That's right.
Self-care is everything.
That's right.
You gotta take care of your own self.
That's right.
So take care of yourself. I love you, man. I'm not done though.
That's right.
But he will cuss you out. This man will cuss you out the same day. Same day. You can work for him. He will cuss you out and ask you, do you want something to eat after? Ezekiel Jenkins. He's a man. We love him. We're going to celebrate him. Not only him, but also after turning 50. We love you both, man. So, congratulations.
So, I want to say happy birthday, Zeke and Zeke.
Come on, son.
Zeke Senior, Zeke Junior.
Yes.
I know Junior don't remember me, but I remember you when you was a baby. Just like Alexis. My goddaughter. I remember them when they was babies. I've been with Zeke. So, let me tell you the truth. Me and Zeke, we didn't know that we knew each other since we were almost in elementary until Ezekiel pulled out a picture. He moved up to Skyway. I had got it was the last day of fifth grade year, and I was always taught not to fight a girl, you know, and so the biggest, tallest girl in the school was bullying up on the kids, and so I told the, she was a white girl, and I told her to run. I said, run on home. Go on, get on. So the bully ran and caught her and said, who told you to run? She said, Anthony. So she came up, and then came with her boy. She had a boyfriend in fifth grade. Are you kidding me? So he was an older dude. She was the tallest girl in school, and so she was like, you've been blowing your trumpet in my ear all year, da da, and pushed me in a bush of thorns. And so I fell in this bush of thorns, and my trumpet flew, and I got up, I walked home. I'm number 12 or 13 kids. I told the whole family. My uncle was there. He's a Muslim. So the whole family just came mobbing down the street. And the Jenkins had just moved into your house. And so they see your whole family coming down the street. And so Zeke and everybody's coming out. And we end up going to South Shore. But we became friends after that. And when I was able to come to Ezekiel's house, Ezekiel showed me a picture, and we was actually friends when we were elementary, but we was actually fighting friends. So we was fighting in the bark. So I remember fighting with Zeke in the bark, or him throwing bark or something, But we have been friends for over 40, it has to be 40 something years, and I have worked with him. He has, he's instilled in a lot of me, and I have to apologize because I call him my pastor. This is my pastor.
Amen.
I call him my pastor because he preaches to me every single time I call him on the phone, and he got a message to say, and we're Bible thumpers, and we're talking about God. We're talking about God. That's we're talking about life, that's but we're right. talking about God.
That's right.
I really appreciate him. This is our third birthday party this year. We had a summer birthday party, I forgive him to this day for inviting people that he didn't know, and kids tearing up the house, the little kids tearing up the house. He still ain't paid all that money that the kids did, he's a landscaper, so as him as a landscaper, how the heck
you gonna let some kids come and tear up our landscape. You know, you don't know the kids. So the whole time I'm thinking these kids is his cousins.
Uh-oh.
And I'm like, okay, give him respect. Okay, little Bobby, and they're a duo, you know. I gotta tell it. This is called what? Chip and Trip?
Roasted toast.
I'm roasting right now. So my man invited a stranger to the house who has the baddest kids in the entire world. The world. You climbing the trees, they tearing out lights, they riding on horses that ain't alive, you know? Like the sprinkler system trying to make it work, pulling it out the ground. Like little gophers. I mean, they were going crazy, but I love you to this day, Zeke. Even I forgave you for that.
Amen.
And your cousin over here, she keeps pinching me like she wants the mic, so she's itching for a scratch. Can you stop touching me, please?
I'm not even touching you. Right. I just did that. I'm not touching you.
Good all the time.
Yes, he is.
All right.
Sweet Jesus.
Zeke, happy birthday. Happy birthday to your girlfriend. Happy birthday, Ezekiel Jr.
She's flashing, but you're not flashing. I thought you were coming here and fly.
And I'm going to pass the mic to my girl, Victoria.
April is my favorite cousin. And because of you, my son has a career.
Beautiful.
And he makes a lot of money now.
Beautiful.
And he's very responsible. And because of you, he has a good job.
Good.
Beautiful. And I always look up to you, and that's why I called this. Okay, can you give my son a chance? And you did that. So I know we haven't seen each other in years, but you are my favorite cousin in the whole world.
Hey! Thank you.
Beautiful. I love you, cousin. I love you. Thank
you. All right. That was Tim. Oh, we have money.
Tim, give the mic to Tim. Give the mic to Tim.
Come on, Timothy.
All right. Ezekiel Anthony. Yeah, which one should I talk about? First.
Ezekiel. Anthony first.
We're going to talk about orange soup first. Came out of the house and said, I got a soup. Like, you know, I'm supposed to match you. You said he Africans and you became in a DJ's. But, you know, man, I appreciate you, man, and you're a wonderful dude, and being married has brought you to another level in life. You've been an excellent, faithful friend to Ezekiel, and I appreciate you guys' relationship and talking about Zeke, but, and you are a wonderful man, and I want you to know that your brother is number 11, and I'm glad to be able to be here on your 50th birthday. And you made it through all the storms and through the rains and the thunders, and you're here at the restaurant that's getting ready to change the name. And Dad is proud of you. No matter what happened in your past, your future is now. And you'll be able to open the door for other people within our community. And we thank you for hanging in there. And you got a beautiful wife that's going to be by your side. Now, Ezekiel! Zeke was, me and Zeke go a long way. When Zeke wanted to be Mr. Vitamin in the neighborhood, I was scared. His first fight, I ran home and got all 13 and said, Ezekiel's fighting, they all came up. But one thing I can say about Ezekiel down through the years, he's a dedicated person to what he believes, what he can do with his hand.
That's right.
And even in being in construction, Zeke, and when you are like really like, you gotta be really neat, like. Don't have no peace. And he get that from Mother Jenkins and Pastor Jenkins, I believe. And Zeke, I wanna say, man, thank you for being my friend. You know, the Lord has brought you through many storms.
Yes, sir.
I mean, even when you went in and you went in skinny, but you came out fat. And you were skinny and you bent your nails. You know, But man, you are like, I look up to you and I appreciate you for the time that you allow me to come and work with you and like, you have literally God with you, bro. Like, God has been with you. His hand is still on you. You have an awesome ministry working with young men. And teaching them how to do landscape, and that's a ministry.
That's a ministry.
You're a pastor within your own godly right, and God preserved you this long so that you can say with generation that they can honor you. When you're gone, they're gonna honor you because you are not an easy man to work with. But your leadership is. They will never forget your leadership because you are a real man. You hear me? And your wife, that's your wife. Is this him?
Yeah.
Yes.
You speaking to us?
But I thank God for both of you guys sticking together and being friends and not allowing any circumstance split you apart.
That's right.
You guys are brothers,
yes.
Stay together,
that's right.
And you guys can change the community by what you do and your boys here.
Yes.
And
today's his birthday. Today's his birthday.
Oh, happy birthday!
Yes.
It's his birthday. Y'all talk about you too. How you been? Okay. So thank you everybody for coming to Anthony and Zeke's birthday party. And I'm going to turn this over to Mother Mary.
Mother Mary.
I really ain't got nothing to say because I've been blinded by Zeke's socks all night long. You got to check out the socks. You got to check out the socks. You got to pay attention from head to toe. And then them socks, they've been doing something all night to me. All night. I can't get over the socks. I don't see no orange in them, but it's okay. It's going to be all right.
Well,
at the end of the day, he seems to be a very upstanding man.
Yes.
I ain't have much time with him, but the little time, he seems to be a very upstanding man. I don't know if he deserved my sister, but that is still yet to be determined, and we'll find out.
Well,
but it sound like, it sound like from what I done heard here, that he the man.
Yeah.
I ain't got nothing to worry about. That's what it sound like. I'm going to find out for myself because I don't believe everything I heard. And them socks, though, them socks. I'm not going to get over them socks. Can't get over them socks. I'm a detailed person. So when your friend said you about that, I was like, oh, he might need to come do some work for me, because I'm about that. And if it slightly off, we going to have a problem. We going to have an issue. So I got some OCD stuff going on, too.
Yes, ma'am.
Real OCD.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm sure my sister done told you. I love my sister to death. We going to be ride or die. You might not know it. Because that's family. But when it comes down to it, family over everything.
That's right.
Family over everything.
Yeah.
Right after Jesus. Right after. So at the end of the day, I'm appreciate, thankful that y'all let me take part in this event. Junior, I see you over there looking real nice.
Yeah.
Nice looking young man.
Yes,
yes
he
is. Yes.
Mr. Anthony, and I ate your food.
Yes.
Appreciate that.
Good.
See you got a little
delicious.
Cross, a little crooked way over here. Way over there, yes. Straightening out. There we go. And that's all.
Happy birthday to my sister, Melissa. She gets on my last nerve.
Uh-oh. Hey, tell the truth. Make it plain. Make it plain.
Talk about it. She's my older sister. She's been tormenting me literally for 45 years. One of my earliest memories of Melissa is her torment. I remember we were really young and we just had a little bit of ice cream left.
Oh,
that's
God.
Enough for one person.
Watch out.
And me, I'm the baby, right? I got the ice cream. And so my sister wanted it. So she told me, come here, Shannon. I'm going to make you a milkshake. Come here. So I gave her the ice cream, not knowing what was going on. You know, I'm 5 years younger than her. So she's stirring it up, y'all. She was like, oh, this is going to be good. Let me taste it. So she took a taste, right? oh, it ain't ready yet, Shannon, it ain't ready. So she kept on stirring it. Let me take a taste, let me take a taste. I was like, is it ready, Melissa? Is it good, is it ready? Not yet. So she kept stirring this ice cream literally for about 5 more minutes, about 20 more times taking taste. And when she finally gave it back to me, it was gone. And I was literally in tears. And I remember looking at her and she was cracking up like she is now. It was so funny to her. And so she's just tormenting me all my life. But Melissa, I love you. You are a beautiful soul. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to all three of you guys.
Amen.
And wishing you many more.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Thank you.
Reason why I am the world's greatest percussionist is because I learned from Ezekiel. We was in drum at South Shore Middle School, uh-huh. And Ezekiel was the let me get off the mic.
Oh Jesus!
Me and Ezekiel, we
said,
Ezekiel, you said, Jesus, before she hear yet? Okay. Ezekiel was the baddest freaking drummer in. Ezekiel was the baddest drummer, and I learned my skills from Ezekiel. I took my skills to another level, but this man was the baddest drummer in Washington. And if he wouldn't got kicked out of South Shore, he would probably still be the baddest. But
he's still the baddest.
He's still the baddest.
Yeah.
He's still the baddest.
All right, I'm passing the mic to Forrest.
Got a triple OG.
Y'all want me to say?
Yes, say.
Man, look, I've been knowing these guys for a very long time, you guys.
Watch out, Doc.
And I'm talking about when I was little. A powerhouse. I tried to play the bongos. Remember the bongos? The bongos, remember them? But I just want to give it up to my loved ones. These guys, we came from very. Tim Davis, I hear you. Where Tim at? I see him. I just want to give Zeke and Israel. Man, Anthony, all y'all, I love y'all. Boogie. Everybody, my loved one right here, I see you.
That's my son.
Hey, man. Hey, Junior, I see you. Man, hey, happy birthday, y'all. The 50th, is it 50th?
Yeah,
Melissa,
she 50.
Melissa, hey, Melissa. I see you. I got a glass eye, y'all, so I can't see everybody. And here we go, y'all.
Take it out. Take that glass eye out. Look in your other eye.
Young man. Grew up in the neighborhood.
Yes.
And somehow they knew when I made rolls. Yes. I don't know how they got the message.
Yes.
But they were at the door. And so I'm famous for lasagna.
Yes.
And
yes.
Rolls.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. He's coming.
But it's amazing here. And I'm also the mother of Anthony Davis.
Yes.
This is my 12th child and my 7th son. And I am 88 years old. So I've weathered the storm. And tonight it is a pleasure to be here. And I want everyone that's here to say good things.
Yes.
To love one another.
Yes.
If there's any ills here, I want them resolved tonight.
Beautiful.
And I want families to be family again, where you can sit around the table and eat together.
Yes, tonight.
and tell them not just tonight. It might not be their family tonight. But find a time where you can say, I'm sorry.
That's right.
That's bigness.
That's it.
To be able to say, I'm sorry. And to turn it around and love.
That's right.
And you'll live longer.
Yes, you will.
You'll live better. And God will bless you. So tonight I don't want to turn this happiness into a sermon.
It's all right. That's all right. Go ahead.
But today is the day that the Lord has made.
Hey, I got the whole Bible in the house, y'all.
Happy New Year, Merry Christmas to everybody, and I want reports. Mother Davis,
yes,
I resolved it.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Mother Davis, I love, and I am being loved. That's important.
Yes, yes.
And so, may the Lord bless you. Honor Reese. Mm-hmm. Live on. I remember when I turned 50, I was so happy. I thought it was going to be the end of my life. But tonight I thank God for life. And I love everybody.
Yes.
I love everybody. I don't meet strangers, and I don't meet, even if you said something bad, I can change it.
That's right.
Into good. So let me quit talking now. Be good.
Amen.
Be good.
Yes.
And I've gained a new daughter-in-law.
Yes.
A new daughter in love, and then one on the way.
All right.
Mr. Ezekiel. So, most of my time around my uncle is at work. Worked on for like 2.5 years.
Two and a half? You made it?
I consider myself one of the last people standing. So, yeah. I'm kind of proud. I don't even know where I begin.
Right, too much.
It's just, you know, some days it'd be just me and him. And you don't want it to be just you and him.
No!
It ain't a good day. No. And sometimes even if there's three people, it still ain't a good day. It don't matter. You bring anybody, it don't matter. But one thing I will say about my uncle, there's a lot of times in the car where he did teach me a lot of things of just about life. And, just to keep going. And, he's tough. He's tough on you. I feel like he's beating you in the ground, but he'll
bite your food.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And that goes to my next story. I remember there's one time at work that was a long day. He asked me to order pizzas, right? So I ordered them. I'm still trying to figure everything out. And then the pizza gets here. It's probably like two big boxes of pizza, right? And it's just me and him. So then, he's like, man, baby, how you gonna order two boxes of pizza? Who gonna eat all that pizza? So then we start, the job's done. We get back in the car. We're driving, and then I start eating my box. And then I look over to him, and like, the entire box is gone. He said, man, who gonna eat all this pizza? He ate the entire box. So I'm like, but, I love my uncle, man. He's taught me a lot. I'm just grateful to have him. He was tough on me, but I actually do need that. That definitely helped me in life. And, And I always remember a lot of the good things he said, and I remember the things other things he said to me. But now I'm just blessed. So I just want to thank you, and happy birthday to you, man.
And
he's a football star. He's going to be a football star.
So, I don't really know what I'm supposed to say, but I know James wants me to say something, and I just want to say,
Hello.
So, James.
Yes, ma'am.
I've been knowing James for a minute. He's been a really good friend to me, a really good friend to my family. He's that dude who you can really count on.
Hey.
Happy 50th birthday.
The 5-0?
I didn't know you was right behind me. But you're literally right behind me.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know your actual birthday.
Sure. What?
December 11th. So that makes you a Sagittarius?
Yes,
or a Cancer?
Yes.
Sagittarius. Happy birthday to you. And I just want to say thank you, James, for inviting me to this tonight. I feel special.
You are special.
I mean, listen. We all special. I know I'm special. Y'all special too. But tonight, James made me feel special because he invited me to come kick it with y'all.
Okay.
I don't even know all of y'all. Well, I met his mama tonight.
Yes.
You know me.
I met Mary.
Yeah.
Anthony. What? You know I'm coming back here. Cornbread. Greens. Rice. Two choices? Coconut and regular? Macaroni and greens. Lordy Jesus. All I'm saying
get the
is,
mic to take
James,
it too. Harry Jenkins.
I'm not going to hold the microphone all night tonight. I'm just saying, you my friend.
You know you my friend. We good.
Hello.
I'm just saying, you my friend. I'm so happy. Listen, I'm 50 years old. I ain't got nowhere to go.
I ain't got nothing to
do. It's my phone.
I went to work tonight. I got off at 6 o'clock. I was like, I'm going to James' party tonight. I don't have an agenda. But I'm so happy to be kicking it with you.
Yes, ma'am.
Y'all saying?
Yes.
And my daddy?
Yes, ma'am.
He
looking for you.
My mama?
Yes, ma'am.
She looking for you. But between me and you, we good. I love you, boo. And I hope we will always be friends. I hope we will always be friends. And I felt like,
Family.
We probably was playing with Play-Doh together way back in the day. Oh no, somewhere.
Yeah, you did. You played the Play-Doh. Hello.
But
hello.
I love you
hello.
And happy birthday.
Thank you.
This person, that person, that person.
decide on the venue. He had to wait till the last minute, okay? Now, he wanted to complain about his workers not being to work on time. But you know, the truth, he's like, okay? But then when it was time for us to make a decision about the venue, he gonna go take the responsibility from someone that was trying to work him, and he gonna take the whole thing on. How you gonna do that?
That's my pastor.
About that. I mean,
that's my pastor.
It's cool and all, but we had something else planned. He just up and took it right out of our hands. So anyway, I got a whole lot to say. I am his older sister. I'm gonna tell you the truth.
Yes.
We is a hot mess. Yes. I'm the first to say it. It's a Negro.
Come on.
To my elders.
Talk
this
about.
I can make you so mad. Psychological with me. I'm still big sis. Cold December 17th. It's what, 20 degrees outside?
Yeah,
but we all here and loving on each other, so thank you all for that. I'm gonna pass the mic, but yeah, thank you.
That's all right. Oh, 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 my Lord.
Back in the back. That's right, y'all. DJ Israel, all the way from Federal Way. Yeah. Hope you had a good time. If you did, well, that's your fault. Yeah.
So it's 10 o'clock, y'all. Turn it up. Let's go.
Ezekiel, and happy birthday to Anthony. I just want to say thank you, Ezekiel, for being my husband's best friend and his pastor. Well, just thank you for the love and support that you've given to Anthony, not only through our relationship and marriage, just as a friend. I honor your relationship. I thank you for being a good friend to him. Anthony, happy birthday, my love. I'm so grateful and happy to be your wife. And I celebrate this 50th birthday with you and every other birthday from here on. Love you. Happy birthday.
Hey, I just wanted to give a shout out to Buki saying happy 50th birthday. We go back to the Powerhouse Church of God in Christ. So I've been knowing you for quite some time. So I just wish that you have a blessed birthday and a blessed 50th celebration. Love you.
Happy birthday, Buki. Wishing you all the best. I remember all of our many days back at Powerhouse having fun. So it is my great wish that you will have 50 more years. Cheers.
Yeah. You covered it.
Yeah.
It's good to be here, and I'm happy to see all these new faces and familiar faces, and it's good to have my dad be 50 years old and see him still being healthy and doing his best in life. And it's good to just be alive and enjoy everything, you know. The small moments, the big moments, the bad moments, it doesn't matter. 25 and thriving, and that's really it.
We should, cause we doing it, and we mean I'm doing it, pursuing it, and we're gonna do great things, are really gonna happen, great things from the great things, hands clapping, yeah, we're going somewhere, we're going all the way to the top, going to where, I'm done with this rap, and don't you see I'm telling you I will never trap you,
I see you, look at you, yeah.
I want to thank God I'm alive.
Earlier
this year, I had a stroke around about April. About a week ago, I got real sick that I really didn't tell anybody about, that I thought I was going to die. I went to go see my mom. Matter of fact, I called my mom and told her that I was going to the hospital. Matter of fact, this was after Anthony's wedding. Then I went to go see my dad, and I was so sick, and I thought I was leaving Seattle. But I thank God he was able to allow me to see today, and I'm here today. Say thank you. So thank you again.
Yeah.
happy birthday to all of them. And many more. Happy 50th, I should say, to Bookie, Ezekiel Jenkins, and Anthony Davis. And many more. And I've been knowing Ezekiel Senior for a long time. We grew up in church together, so we go all the way back knee high. And he's really a good dude, and he is one of my best friends, platonic friends, as a male. Happy birthday to all of you. Thank you.
All right, what we doing?
All right, this is the Jenkins brother.
Oh, wait a minute.
Wait, how are you?
Thank
what's,
you.
What's the prompt? What's the prompt?
Oh, you guys made it.
Oh.
Okay, you
oh.
Made it.
Listen. All right. Hey, let me say this right here. One of the youngest cousins of this guy here, but here's what I will say. Growing up, there was nobody single-handedly more influential than this guy right here. Little cousin Tony wanted to do and be just like cousin Bookie. Literally, everything I want to do. This is like my idol. He probably won't believe me, but literally, I try to just emulate everything this guy did. But knowing this King story, man, I'm so proud to call this guy family. But bruh, seeing you on your 50th, man. Hey, Boo. Man, life is too
representing your brand is too proud.
Man, for sure, man. That's love, man. That's love. To make 50 is a blessing, bruh.
Thank you, sir.
Like, it's a blessing, man. And I love you. I'm so proud of you, too, man. Business owner, dope father, extraordinary son. And, man, this year, man, you get so much love, man.
I'm very humble.
You get love and respect from me, though, cousin.
I'm very humble to be able to say this is my cousin. He's a well-groomed man. He's a very well-groomed man. His face shines in the community. You probably know him just by his face. Look at his smile.
He's got something else.
You know, and I am very thankful and honored to say I appreciate you coming, cuz. I love you.
Yeah. I love you too, man.
You know what I'm saying? Nothing but respect for this man right here. He's representing a fine brand. Mr. Tony Shoeprap. Thank you, sir.
Man. I appreciate you, man.
Yes,
love
sir.
You, man.
Love you too, sir.
Off
thank
top.
You, sir.
Of course,
yes,
man.
Sir.
You're not going to miss this, man.
Watch out,
hey,
sir.
Happy 50th. And I'm gonna give a shout out to 50 Mo, and we out.
It's my cousin Jimmy.
What's up, y'all? What you got there?
I mean, what can I say about my cousin Jimmy? He's a well-rounded man, entrepreneur, Seattleite, beautiful, great heart, honest man. I am very honored to say this is my cousin. Jimmy, you probably know his face.
We are the both. What he's saying is a reflection of himself. That's the same thing. We are both the same.
So, lady?
Yes, this is my cousin Jimmy right here. This is my cousin. This is my cousin Jimmy. This is my mom's side.
Well, I'm going to say something about this man right here. Self-explanatory. Look at it.
We got Serge in the house.
Self-explanatory. Look at it. Self-explanatory. I mean, mere image of myself is this man right here. Happy 50th, cousin. Love you, pal.
And I love you. Happy birthday, cousin. I love you too.
All day.
It's okay. This is my cousin right here. Businessman. Entrepreneur. Know who he is. Put that camera on him. Know who he is. Businessman, entrepreneur, single man, Mr. Surge.
Go ahead, I'm gonna listen.
We got Mr. Surge in the house. Very unique, well-rounded man, family man, unique man. You probably know his face in the community. He's a person that is round and known in the community. Person that I respect. I am honored to say and pleasant to say Mrs. Surge is here to celebrate a phenomenal day with us. Mr. Surge, please.
I just keep
like
it short.
Like that jacket, man.
I just keep it short. I just didn't say happy birthday. Saying many, many, many moons ago, we met. You know what I'm saying? And then we're still here to celebrate this milestone of a birthday. And I'm glad to see you here, healthy, prosperous.
And I mean, just let the stars take you where they're going to take you.
Yes, sir.
But you, I know you're going to put in the work. And I always appreciate you. When I have an issue, the employees just questions, I'm able to call you, and I thank you.
Yes, sir.
That you give me the opportunity to be able to call you.
Yes, sir.
I know. Just thank you for paving the way. Yes, like you. Happy birthday, my guy.
I appreciate you so much. Like that jacket, man. Don't hurt me too much, man.
All right, did you tribute?
Don't hurt me too much.
Yeah, come on here.
Yeah. And
this is my wife.
This is the boss lady.
Just want to say, wishing you a happy and blessed 100. Right? You 100. May God continue to watch over, bless, use, and use you as a vessel to do what you need to do for carry out your purpose. Live life and do all that you're supposed to do. Happy birthday.
I'm so grateful to be able to share this moment with a true friend that I've been knowing for so many years, that we have so many stories that we don't have enough time to be able to share. But this man is very brilliant. One thing I can say about this man, I love his imagination. I really do and love his faith. This man has a really strong imagination. And his faith is very strong. And that is something that I always have gravitated to and always honor and respect. You know, not too many people could be able to think out the box and be able to create things and make things and believe in things. One thing I can say for this man right here, I was able to see it, hear it, but also live it. That's facts. You know, facts. So with that being said, this is Mr. Anthony Davis. You know, he's more than just a friend. He's like a brother, a cousin. You know, he's like
family.
Man, he's like my twin, but we don't look alike. I'm a little darker. He's from the Banana Tribe. I'm a little darker, but he's from Banana Tribe.
For real.
But you know what I'm saying? But you know, check this out. A real man. Yeah. I'm very proud of him being married, found a wife. I'm very proud of that. I thank you for having that opportunity to be, you know, part of your marriage and see it.
Best man.
Man, I appreciate it. Love you, bro.
Love you, too. Yo, y'all, we partied. We had a good time. Man, come on. We got family, everybody, friends. We're having a party, y'all. Come on. You want to come say something? We got people who want to come say on the mic. You know what I'm saying? This man is worthy of all. Everything, 50 years, man, he's a leader, you know what I'm saying, hard worker, man, encourager, and preacher, pastor. This is my pastor, y'all. I appreciate this man every single day. Real talk. We're gonna do more and greater things. Y'all see. Come on. It's my wife right here, Rosie.
Come on, Rosie.
This is my wife over here. She's not scared of him. There she go. Talk to him, baby.
Happy birthday again.
Go ahead, Melissa. You want to take something to the people?
Well, I just want to say happy birthday to Bookie and myself and Anthony and Zeke Jr. Hallelujah, amen, praise God.
That's right, y'all. It's the Nighthawk, y'all. Nighthawk. Oh, we got two.
Yeah. What up? This is Dr. Dre. The party's going on. Thank God it's Friday.
We got the 12 o'clock DJ coming at DJ Saw. All the way from Kent coming next.
No.
Your body was inspired.
All my people back there.
That's something that's been right. I had to
with my life for sure, my wife for sure. No turning back, so crack it. No satisfaction, girl, that's what's happening.
I play a big game, you know my name. Ass jackets to the bad times split. A man need a lady, no matter the kind of dime. Shouting like, you know it's hard to find.
Time is changing, change for its time. My nephew won't shoot, cause you suck.
The woman choose a man is a real monkey. Make your choice, it's way to wait, you know what I mean. Being smooth to go hard, real baby. That's why you think that you want to have.
There's something special about you, baby. You want me to know about you right now, but you really gotta do it.
Get a piece of that apple pie. Every game ain't the same, cause the game still remains. Don't it seem kinda strange? Ain't a damn thing changed. If you don't work, then you don't eat. And only down ass niggas can ride with me. Hop, 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 if I quickly down the block. Stay sucker free and keep the busters off your jock. You gotta have heart, son, if you wanna go. Watch this sweet chariot swing.